Hello.
Oh God, I'm so warm. It's really strange weather, and my light is also very strange. Now I'm inside, so I hope there will be no bugs. And I have actually fixed, so I will get a table. I hope I will get it tomorrow. When you see this, it will be today. And then I can set up a permanent filming location in my makeup room. And if everything goes as planned, I will get a visitor next Saturday in a week from now. And we will film two videos together. That will be so fun. But you know, I don't want to jinx it because everything can happen. You know, people can get sick, things can happen and so on. But the plan is at least, and then the videos will probably go up shortly after that. But yeah, today I'm doing part 6 with my lovely friends Linda and Malin. And today in our Jeffree Star series, and today it's Blue Blood. Yay! So it will be 6. Kind of. I have not used my Blue Blood yet, so this will be interesting. And I don't know if you remember, but the last time we had a big palette, the blood sugar. Let's see if I can remember correctly now. I picked shades for Linda and Malin picked for me. So now it has to be Linda that picked for me and I picked for Malin and Malin picked for Linda. So we picked 3 mattes and 2 shimmers for each other. It looks like I'm so dark. I don't know. I look terrible, but yeah, it's warm. And you can see the shade she picked here. Let's see, let's open this up. I'm getting messages all the time. But yeah, so it's really hard to hold up, but it looks like this, as you all may know. And I got mint tea, that shade, crystal flesh, I hate the word flesh, but yeah, that one, blue Monday, flourishing, it says flourishing, right? Flourishing, yeah, flourishing, and entitled. I'm just looking because some of these pants I had to push back in, but yeah. Oh, let's do it like that. And I have swatched them for you here. So I think I have a plan. Yeah, we'll see. The only thing I know is that I'm going to start with mint tea and see where we will. I'm going to take this away because blue have a tendency of staining me. And by the way, if you have not watched our collab last Sunday with the Alien palette, you have to go and watch Malin's video. That is one of the most hilarious videos I have watched all this year. I laughed so hard when I watched it, because I was so lucky, because we did kind of like a palette bingo, but we have pre-decided in what order we are going to put them on the lid, and she was not as lucky as I was. It was so fun. You have to go and watch that. Linda's video is also amazing, but Malin had such bad luck. It was so fun. But yeah, oh, let's prime maybe. Oh, this is going to be soon. I love blue eyeshadow, but I don't use them as often as I used to do. Like that. Oh, I hope I will feel better now and get, you know, back on track, because I have fixed everything, so it should be easier for me to record, and I just have a few steps left, and I hope that will get, you know, I still think it's fun, it's that's nothing to do with that, but you know, the I was about to say will to live, but that was not what I was going to say at all. But I'm so tired, you know. It's kind of like, you call it fatigue, right? So I don't have the energy to do anything, even though it's fun. I'm going to drink. Yeah, so I hope everything will be back on track soon. Okay, ooh, whoops. And I have obviously not done my base. Let's see. I hate, you know, because some of these pants looks like they are almost coming out. They are not properly put in, and I don't want to press them because, you know, that I don't want to press into the eyeshadow. But I hate that, you know, quality control. Like, you know, the glitter shade, Ocean Eyes, and Minty, and Crystal Flesh, and, you know, a lot of shades are almost popping out. Did I just get eyeshadow over here? No. Okay, mint tea it is. Let's see. Now I'm taking a very fluffy brush, so it's not showing up as much as it did when I swatched it, but it was a very buttery matte, or what you're going to call it. I will probably use this more, but we start here. Like that. Like that. Gumball, är du här i området? It is, you know, I feel like not everything is like it should be, because I don't feel like talking too much and I don't have a lot of things to say right now, which is weird because I usually feel like I have a lot to say. Maybe I will come up with something, but yeah. By the way, I filmed, because when I did my declutter, I have had a lot of makeup that I was going to throw out. Either because it was very old, or it was used so much that, you know, I can't give it away and I wouldn't use it myself. So it was going to be thrown away. And I did, you know, sit down and just destroyed some lipstick, some eyeshadow, some bronzers. I just destroyed a lot of makeup. And I filmed when I did that, but I don't think the footage were that good. I don't think it would be, it would not be in detail, you know, like a lot of people do, but I will see. Maybe I will put it up, I don't know. I thought it was kind of fun, and I still have a lot of eyeshadow, but they are not, they are eyeshadow palettes, and I said that I didn't declutter any, but these are, you know, fakes that I have bought from Wish, and I just have some, you know, because I really wanted packaging and thought, you know, maybe I could take out eyeshadow and repress new ones and still have the packaging and so on, but, you know, it's very cheap packaging as well, and yeah, I'm just going to throw them, but I want to destroy them first because it's very satisfying. This showed up a lot. I like that. Let's see. This is still yellow from my yellow look. Let's see if there is some bugs as well. I'm going to take that. And let's take, I think we're going to take Flourishing. looks very fan heter det. Blue green sea foamy, but when I have this shade under it looks more turquoise. And always when I do this, I realize that I should have taken the first shade higher up. But that's why you can go back and blend. Blend, 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 blend. Oh, I'm so excited to get that table in the room so I don't have to, you know, set up this. And I will have a different background because I will probably be sitting the other way around, like I did in some of my videos, but now I will have a better table and yeah, everything will be better, I hope. And the next thing on my buy list, buy as in shop, is a ring light and then another soft box, I think. And when I have that, I will try to use the camera that I bought from Angelica. Because it's a shame that it's only lying in the drawer, but you know, I want everything to be as good as it can get, and then I will try to use that, because I think it will be a struggle to use it, because I'm not used to using that type of camera, and I'm not used my computer. I bought a MacBook was it a month ago? I think it was more than a month ago, but I haven't used it that much now because I'm not used to using a computer that much at home, because I have been without or with a really bad one for such a long time that I'm used to doing everything on my iPad or my iPhone. So I really have to, you know, get into that again, but I think I will do that when I have a proper workstation as well. And then I can film with that. Because right now it will be quicker and easier for me to upload with my phone. Now let's take mint tea again. Over here. Because this shade really took over. But now it looks more like it does in the pan. Let's leave it like that for now. And now I'm going to take Blue Monday. Really blue, blue. These are usually never that pigmented, these types of blues. They look very intense, but then when you put them on the eye, they just disappear. That's so weird, but we'll see how this looks. Fine so far. I don't want to ruin the pattern because there is a cloud with a lightning bolt in this one. Well, I have high hopes because it's Jeffree Star and he usually has good quality, and so far it looks nice, but they are usually a bit harder to blend out as well, just like purples. I don't know why I have that brush, but yeah. I'm just taking the one that I had before. Because some shades may look awesome, but then in like 30 minutes they would have faded away totally. And these types of shades usually do that. Hmm. Are we going to try a halo eye today? Because I never do halo eyes. Let's try. This may be the wrong idea, but now we are doing it. Ooh. It's really pigmented over here at least. I picked some really fun shades for... It has to be Malin, right? So we'll see what she does. And Linda as well, of course. And then we'll see if Malin buys the new Jeffree Star palette, but I don't think it will be right now because she's going on a low buy. But if she does, then we will do, you know, part 7. But for right now, this is the final part. Like that. I'm going to fix this a bit when I have done the shimmer. Like that. And I'm going to take... the entitled one, the blue, turquoise, whatever. Smakar du, Gumball? Gumball is snoring. So weird because I always do, usually I do the base first and then I do my eyes. But when I do my eyes first, I always do the under eye before I do the base. But I have noticed that I don't think I can think of anyone that does that. They always do the base and then the under eye. But you know, I always think that if there is something that is falling down, it's from the under eye, so... And I don't have a problem because I don't apply concealer or anything like that, so... I'm not that close to the eye anyway. Like that, and then I want to use mint tea again. Blow it out a bit here. Then I'm going in with Blue Monday again, when I've done that. Looks always looks more crazy when I look there. This is so pigmented that it almost layer on top of the other shade. That is good, especially for a pastel like that. What if Jeffree Star did a pastel palette? And a neon palette as well. And if Colourpop did that. Because Jeffree Star has a lot of pastel shades in some of his palettes, but if he could, you know, pull them together. It looks a bit patchy over there, so we're going to put some more blue on. I have not forgotten about the last shade, so don't you worry. I could even cover up my mistake with that pastel shade. That's awesome. Take this brush. I have ordered brushes from ColourPop. I hope they have one that I could use for this. I don't feel like going through the brushes I have, but I have to do that if there isn't one in the ColourPop order. I don't want to use this one for this. It's not even. Now I have, purposely blended out the shades a lot more than I usually do, but because I want it to be like that, kind of diffused. And then we're going to take, what was that called? Crystal Flesh. I don't know if this will be too dark to have an inner corner, but we're going for it. Because I have a dark look. That it looks really crazy when I look like this. When I look here, doesn't do that here. But I'm going to clean this up and put on my base and something in the waterline and everything, and then I will be back. Hello. Wait. My eye is tearing up. So the blue shade disappears from here all the time. But yeah, now my look is done and it looks so much better in the mirror than it does in the camera. That's fascinating. Let's move it over here. But yeah, I put the Zulu liner from ColourPop in my lower lash line, and I have blush and highlighter from Hourglass. And on my lips, I have, was it Lovecraft from Kat Von D? She has the best liquid lipstick. And it's also Kat Von D that I have used as a contour. It looks so much dirtier or patchier or darker or whatever in the camera than it does in real life. That's so weird, because this shade up here almost doesn't show in the camera, but it really shows here. Did I put that brush back? Are you kidding me? There. So weird. Just taking a bit more so you can see it. But I'm pretty pleased anyway. It looks nice in real life, and that's what's important. And I got the shades that Linda, I think it is Linda that picked these for me. And it was Mint Tea, that one, and Crystal Flesh, and Blue Monday, and Flourishing, and titled, right? Yeah, untitled. So yeah, and I used crystal flesh in a corner, just yeah. And I'm pretty pleased. So I'm excited to see what Malin and Linda creates. And unfortunately, this will be the last part in this collab series for now. We'll see if there will be a part 7 in the future, but not right now. But maybe we will come up with something else, because it was so much fun to do this with friends and to use palettes and do different things with them. So yeah, I know I look terrible, but yeah. Now I'm going to do some other stuff. So go check out Malin and Linda and have a nice day.